look around you, there are many things to see that some would say could never be. These things I know, it's true, and I will tell you so. They are there to see for you and me. Trolls and wizards and fairy kings, birds that talk and fish that sing, and if your heart is true, then you will find them too. In every wish and dream and happy home, you will find the kingdom of the gnomes. That's the theme song to David the Gnome. I thought it would be fun to read it, and most people watching this probably don't get the reference, because it's a very old cartoon. Anyway, I thought it would be cool to draw some gnomes, so that's what I did. And yeah, this is an adventuring party of gnomes, and they are about 6 inches tall, and one of them's a wizard, and one of them's a fighter there, and one of them has like a shepherd's crook. And now I'm working on this, this one's basically Robin Hood, and yeah, so Robin Hood is there too, as a gnome. And then this is my last one. I wanted to do a big tall one here. And yeah, I wanted to run the gamut of like different heights and different sizes and different shapes and play with all sorts of different little designs of gnomes. And I thought that would be neat. I did something a little out of the ordinary with this one too. I put all the ink on one layer, because it just saved time rather than doing every individual person as a fully rendered character, which I realized there's just no reason to do that, because this is going to be one still image. So I did go through and sketch them all out individually so I could reposition them and stuff, but once I figured out where I wanted them to be, I put them all kind of just on one layer, and there's the inking. But I actually broke up... I did one character at a time and like rendered all the colors out of them, and really I probably shouldn't have done that because I ended up having to go back and like spot fix some few things, and it made it a little confusing to me because I forgot which things were on which layer and which colors went where. So what I should have done was inked the whole thing and then just colored them all at once, but I don't know, I kind of thought maybe it might make the video slightly more interesting, because rather than watching all of the sketching and then all of the inking and then all of the coloring, it's kind of like watching 5 mini videos here, because I fully render every character kind of by themselves. But I guess you have to let me know if that was more interesting or not. I there was no real practical reason to do it. It actually was, it made drawing this more complicated than it needed to be, but the one reason I stuck with it is I thought, well, maybe it'll make the video more interesting to watch, and maybe it did, maybe it didn't. I'm also playing a lot with, like, the textures and stuff. I was kind of really happy with how most of the hair went, and I decided that to play with different texture brushes for, like, the different materials that they might be wearing, and that's... Hopefully it looks good. I ended up being pretty happy with the result. But, yeah, and I put this, mainly just for scale, I gave this Robin Hood character a little clover in his hat instead of, like, a pheasant feather. So you can see, like, that's how big they are. It's like a little clover. And, yeah. And he's got a little shillelagh there and some arrows, and he's just Robin Hood. He's probably the least inspired of the rest of them, but I thought he looked cool enough that I wanted him to stick around. This one here, I'm really happy with this guy's beard. I didn't look at this when I was drawing this, but it kind of really reminds me of the art style of the caricatures in the animated Spellbook, which is a YouTube series that, this character in particular reminds me of one of their characters. And maybe I'll actually look at that character after recording this and see if they look similar at all, because I could just be misremembering it. And this doing this fur coat I thought was really neat. And yeah, so these are gnomes. These are all the leaders of different tribes of gnomes, and they've all come together to like have a meeting to discuss like politics and stuff. And I decided why not have a rainbow behind them. So here is the finished adventuring party of gnomes, I guess. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like this drawing. And thanks.